planning on heading out of town for the 4th of July.
Why not take 10 minutes to do a pre-trip checkup? That's
there
a hard one to say. You need to do that on your car, and our Monday morning mechanic, David Rogers from Keller Brothers Auto Repair, is here showing off what you should do before you leave town. Hi, David.
Well, hi, Natalie. How you doing?
Good.
Pre-trip checkup.
They're important.
Yeah,
we
job.
Were trying to decide if we could do that three times fast. Three times maybe, but never fast. Hey, you know, you're right. We're looking at everyone getting on the road this weekend with gas prices high. The last thing you can afford to do is have a breakdown, right? We're talking tow trucks and the whole thing. The first thing to do and to think about when we travel always is fluids. You know, you've heard me beat this in for years. There's so many fluids that are critical that we don't think about every day. You know, you've got brake fluid in there. You know, we always think about replacing the pads, but not the fluid. You know, a brake fluid, when it gets bad, is caustic. It's going to eat the rubber seals and the components that hold the fluid inside, and therefore going to leak on the ground, and you're not going to be able to stop. Coolant's another critical fluid. Obviously, it keeps us from overheating in the engine. But, you know, many people may not know that coolant, you know, picks up the rust inside the car. When you have when the radiator starts to rust internally, or the water pump, then it settles to the bottom of your radiator, just like it did in this test tube, and it continues to eat away at the metal. So sometimes it can look okay in the reservoir up top, but then down in the bottom there's a problem. So it's important to flush it out every other year, whether you think you need it or not. Even if you're carrying an extended life product, you know, some of these coolants now claim to last for 100,000 miles. I don't buy into any of that. I've seen way too many systems that were damaged terribly, and I tell people change it anyway. Your transmission fluid too. Not only does this stuff lubricate the transmission, but it helps keep it cool, just like antifreeze or coolant does on the radiator. Nice red, bright, clear color. When it starts to get, you know, burnt orange all the way to brown like this, it's really not doing its job anymore, and in fact could cause some problems. Another thing that we think about are belts when we travel. Now, if you look here, you can kind of see how this belt's got some cracks. You can see the cracks down inside the grooves, I think. And those cracks are indicative that the belt is just about to break. So we certainly wouldn't want to have that when we're on the way to the 4th of July celebration at the lake. So maybe better just to go ahead and get a belt installed. Hoses as well. A hose can look perfectly fine on the outside. You know, this hose doesn't particularly look bad. But when you squeeze it, you go, my goodness, it almost feels like there's a hard hose inside of a soft hose. When I push on this, it kind of is a little bulged right there. Well, what's happening internally is that hose is deteriorating, and typically hoses break down from the inside out. So if you wait until you have a leak or until you can see a problem, it's already too late, and you're already, you know, at a point that's critical, and you're going to have to repair it. Hoses should be replaced about every 4 years. That's going to save you a lot of trouble. A few more fluids I have here, of course, some gasoline. The gas samples out there today are just horrendous. I mean, this literally came out of a consumer's gas tank. Should have looked like that. Instead, we get that. Well, that tells us we need to change the fuel filter, and then also the air filter so the car can breathe. That'll save you some gas mileage on your trip. Now, lastly, and probably most critically, are tires. You know, we did the penny test for years, and used to what we would say is to use a penny and put it head down in the tire, put it head down in the tire tread, and look for it to be just shy of what used to be Abraham Lincoln's head. We're saying now switch to the quarter, because that's a 4/32nd measurement. What you do is you look for these little wear bars in your tire grooves. You see the little bar that goes across, and you set the quarter there. Now, this one's even, so there's no tread left here at all. Zero, zilch, nada. You don't wait till it's bald. You don't wait till it's steel. You wait till you have 4/32nds at the wear bar. So take your quarter, drop it inside. Now, this is a brand new tire. There's plenty, plenty, plenty. I'm sure you can see there's plenty of tread in that tire. It goes up over his head. But where you're looking for, when it gets about to the scalp, it's time to replace. That can change your stopping distance by 100 feet. So think about that on wet pavement. You'll stop 100 feet sooner if you replace those tires at 4/32nds instead of waiting until 2/32nds.
So remember Washington's scalp. Got it.
Washington's scalp. Use the quarter upside down.
A lot of good information.
Thanks, David.
All right,
appreciate it.
Have a great day.
Yeah, and safe travels for the 4th of July.